Hello everyone, welcome back again to JN Electric YouTube channel.
A beautiful wooden pattern room is very quiet without the presence of a music. Therefore, let me present a technical overview of the very popular JBL 4367 speaker system. This JBL 4367 has a maximum power capacity of about 300 watts at 6 ohm load woofer reproduction for the frequency range below 700 Hz, a 2-to-1 6ND, 1 differential drive woofer which approaches 38 cm diameter, supported by 2 4 Bass-reflex channel is responsible, just as with the horn driver. JBL can also rely on the proven life and studio technology in the low frequency range. Thus, the design of the woofer has the high efficiency, mechanically durable and compact, edge lightweight loudspeaker design, which a characteristic by low head production, high pulse speech, and minimal distortion even under high load. As with the horn driver, JBL is using a dual concept. Two coils are used in practice. The woofer proves to be an excellent playing partner for the horn driver, which lower the frequency spectrum, which is the very effective performance which physically clearly producible is the higher volume without the sounding entity or the event obstructive. JBL 4367 is offered by several speaker manufacturers at the price of $16,500 per pair. Why is a speaker crossover needed? The entire audio frequency range of approximately 40 Hz to 20 kHz cannot be handled by one driver and speaker. In fact, if the interspectrum is directed to single driver and speaker, then output is less optimum and distorted. The speaker driver are designed for the specific audio frequency range. Operating them outside this range could damage the driver speaker. Of course, extreme distortion, not a good thing. Basically, crossover are a combination of resistor, inductor, and capacitor, even diode, specific array that are frequency specific. A high pass filter block all my mid range and low frequency, passing only the high frequency signal. A low pass filter blocks all high frequency signal and pass only low frequencies. The crossover network is installed between the amplifier and speaker and usually does not require any external power to operate it. The majority of crossover networks are mounted on printed circuit board or there are hardwired one component to the next tie, which the tie wraps the cable tie and affixes the speaker cabinet. And thank you for watching. See you next time.